of ready to hop back in that bag, to be honest, because it just feels right. Hey guys, so I just finished getting my lashes done. They look a lot darker than normal. We did them a little bit more full because I have a problem with picking them. I don't know why I do it, but whatever. I am starving and I'm trying to decide what I'm about to do now. I think I'm gonna go to my P.O. box. It's literally 9:15. It's very early. I don't really have anything planned for today. Anything specific anyway. I don't know. I just felt like I wanted to vlog today. So here we are. Actually, I'm not going to my P.O. box. It doesn't look like my package is there yet. So I don't know what I'm about to do. I guess I'm about to go back home. I'm about to get something to eat though. What do I want? Kind of want some hash browns. I'm really on a hash brown kick right now. But I don't know. I went to bed kind of early last night and it was really nice. My last appointment was at 8 a.m. So I had to get up early. But I had a good night's sleep. Now I'm trying to figure out what I'm doing for the weekend. I need to do some content for my business page. And I probably need to take some more outfit pictures to post. I've been having fun doing those. But I need some more clothes. Not even for pictures, but just in general. Like, I just feel like I don't have anything to wear. I mean, no. I just have too many loungewear clothes, which y'all know I love. I'm never gonna not have endless loungewear clothes. But I don't know. I just need some more, like, outfits, like, to do stuff. Because I haven't been to brunch in a very long time, actually. Now that I'm thinking about it, what the heck? My friends that are watching this, why have we not gone to brunch? I have not been to brunch and it feels like it's going on 2 months, quite honestly. Yeah, it's about 2 months since I've been to brunch. That's problematic. That is extremely problematic. And I don't like it. So yeah, I'm gonna have to, maybe I'll go to brunch tomorrow. Like, what's it giving? Let me check the weather. I'm very big on weather. If the weather is not gonna be nice, I can't be outside. I just can't. I need it to be nice when I go out. But I don't like that for me. How am I gonna be the brunch queen? I haven't been to brunch in 2 months. Like, that's not normal. Okay, 72, overcast. I don't know. Today would have been a nice day for brunch. Actually, is it too late to go to brunch today? I kind of want to go to brunch today. But let me see what people is doing. Because, like, what the heck? I deserve to go to brunch. Okay, anyway, let me figure out what I'm doing. Because I'm feeling like I want to go to brunch. It's giving brunch. Like, it's giving brunch. So, let me gather the troops. Let me get the gang together and see what's good. Hey, guys. I'm back. So, all of my friends are doing other things. So, no brunch. I don't know why I'm so thirsty to be outside today. Well, it's really nice. That's why. And it's been a while, like I said, since I've done anything. But that's okay. I'm on my way to the post office now. And I literally... Oh, you are flying, Mini Cooper. So, yeah. I don't know what kind of mood I'm in today. I mean, I do. But I don't know. It's like I have plenty of things that I can be doing, like productive things that I need to be doing, actually. But like, I just was at home for like the last 5 hours and I literally just sat on the couch and didn't do anything. Like, I didn't even have the TV on. I was just on my phone. So, I don't know. Today might be a wash for being productive because like, I really just don't feel like doing anything productive. Maybe I'll get a second win. I don't know. So yeah, I don't know what I'm about to do after this. I don't know. I'm just so pressed and I don't want to be in the house. But also it's like, what we about to do? We about to waste gas driving around? Maybe. Actually, with y'all going crazy making the gas short, we can't be wasting gas. So I don't even know. Can I even ride around and just like shoot the breeze? I don't know. I got about a half a tank. I don't know why he's looking at me. This man literally just literally was staring at me. On my next car, I have to get my windows tinted. I have no idea why I didn't tint these windows, but next car, I have to tint it. I can't be in a fishbowl anymore. But yeah, so it's just one of those days. I'm not even in a mood. I'm just like, you know, you just want to be outside. I just want to be outside. I want to hang out with my friends, enjoy the nice weather, but it just isn't meant to be today, and that's okay. So, better go in here and get my little package. I look so stupid holding this thing, but I didn't feel like putting my camera on the mount. So, here we are. I don't know why people do stupid things like park their car where it's not a parking spot. All right, I gotta park, and this camera's gonna fall if I do it, so BRB. Okay, y'all, so I got my package, and I just decided I want crabs. I think that will make me happy, so we're gonna go do that. I don't even know if they're gonna have the size available that I want, because it's really nice out and it's a Saturday, but we just gonna go there and see what it's hitting on. So hopefully they will have the size that I want. And that's what I'm gonna do. That's how I'm gonna spend my day with me, is by indulging in some crabs. I'm actually very excited about it. I know it doesn't seem like it, but I'm hyped because today is the perfect day for that. I need to clean off our deck because I should go. But yeah, it would be nice to eat them outside on our deck, but she needs a little cleanup. So I'm just gonna probably eat them in our sunroom where it's sunny. So yeah, that's what we're about to do. That's the adventure that we're gonna go on right now. I kind of want a drink from Starbucks. Not a coffee drink, like a refresher. Maybe a pink drink or a green tea lemonade. I don't know. Green tea lemonades are so refreshing. I think I want one. Do I pass a Starbucks on the way? Where's the drive-through? I don't really want to get out. In other news, how excited are we that Nikki just put Beam Me Up Scotty on iTunes? I mean, Apple Music, sorry. Apple Music, where did iTunes come from? I don't know, it's given 2007. But yes, so excited. I can't believe how nostalgic all of Friday felt for me. Actually, it was really Thursday night / Friday midnight time, because as soon as it dropped, I played it. And it brought me back to, like, oh my gosh, I remember vividly, like, was that my freshman year? It was like end of freshman year or beginning of sophomore year. I can't really remember, of college. But oh my gosh, when Nikki and Drake were on the come up, like when they were climbing, like they were, I'm not gonna say their peak, but it was that moment in time in their career where they were skyrocketing. Like it was, oh my gosh, that was such a good era. Like, oh my gosh, so many memories. Yeah, I don't know. I just really enjoyed that. And I'm super hyped that it's finally on Apple Music so I can stop having to listen to it on Spinrilla, because I don't like having to switch between like streaming apps. That's really annoying. I mean, granted, I still have to, because like freaking Days Before Rodeo is still not on iTunes. What do I keep saying iTunes? Still not on Apple Music, so I have to get on SoundCloud to listen to that. Anyway, I'm really excited about that. J. Cole's new project is obviously fire. I mean, what isn't fire that he does? So it's been a good couple days for music. I've been enjoying the tunes. And I'm excited about summer. I mean, I was already excited about summer, but good music just makes me even more excited. Like now I feel like I need to take fire pictures, because there's just so much, like, so many captions. And I really don't even be putting captions like that anymore, like quote captions or like bars as captions anymore. But I'm kind of ready to hop back in that bag, to be honest, because it just feels right. So yeah. What else? Like, what's going on with you guys? I'm not gonna share a lot about it here, because I'm actually thinking about maybe doing another video explaining like what's kind of going on in my life right now. But you'll probably already know what I'm talking about by the time you see this vlog, quite honestly, because if I do the video I'm referring to, that's already gonna be up by now. But yeah, life is real crazy right now, y'all. Like it's just real crazy. And it's just like, you know, when you, I don't know, it's like, I don't want to call it the trenches, but when you be going through it, like having a lot of stuff on your plate and just like trying to maneuver through life just in general, it just seems like those times where it just seems like nothing is right and you still trying to be optimistic, but literally every time you think you're about to do something and it's about to be like good, or you're about to like cross something off or cross a bridge, it's like life is like, nah, actually take 3 steps back for me, homie. Like, actually you're not about to complete this step. You're not about to go to the next level yet. I'm not done knocking you down, so like reel it back in. Don't get excited yet. I know I'm speaking very loosely, but that's just like, it keeps happening. Like, it's been happening to me a lot lately. Like, yeah, I'm not even making really much sense probably to you guys, but it's just crazy, because like honestly I'm to the point in my life where literally every time I feel like I am about to get emotional about something or get like worked up about it, I literally just be like, it is what it is, like whatever. I can't be bothered. Sir, please get over or speed, like slow down or speed up. I don't know what to tell you. But yeah, it's just like, I can't be bothered. Like, I choose happiness. I choose calmness. Like, I can't let anything like disrupt me from being like at peace. Like, I just won't. It's just like, I just been through a lot of stuff just in my life in general. And it's just like, anything else now is literally just like, all right, okay, what's next? What's next? And that's not to be like negative or anything. It's just like, we're just to the point where it's just like, I'm just not phased, or I try really hard not to be phased, because at the end of the day, like, things are going to be what they're going to be. And it's really, a lot of things are out of your control. So like being emotional, okay, I have to go around you. Being emotional or getting worked up about things generally does nothing help any situation. So it's just like, I'll save that energy for something else. So yes, I've been actively trying to do that in my life, and it actually is effective because I don't get overwhelmed as easily. Now obviously I'm not saying I never get overwhelmed, because I definitely do. I suffer in silence a lot, which is crazy. Not intentionally, not because I don't have anybody to talk to. Like, I have a good circle around me of people who are supportive, that I can, like, you know, cry on their shoulder if I want, if I needed to. But I'm just the type of person that I just don't. I just be suffering in silence. Because by the time I share it with you and we talk about it, like, I be over it. So it's like no point really. And I don't know. That just always have been like that. I'm not really like an emotional person. So it's like, I don't really like sharing like things that make me emotional or make me like, I don't know how to explain it, y'all. But basically, yes, I handle a lot of things by myself and keep them to myself. For real, my grandmother was really the only person that I would like confide in. So it's just like, I don't know. I don't even really feel like, you know what I'm saying, having taken up energy in my body with like things that annoy me. Like, is that, does that make sense? Like, I just be so, I don't know. I don't know what that, I don't know if I'm jaded now or if, I don't know. I don't know if I don't know what that is. But anyway, because I'm definitely rapping right now. Like, I'm legitimately rapping, and that is, yeah. So anyway, I don't even know where I was going with that spiel just now, because it literally, now I've lost the train of thought. So anyway, we're going to get crabs because that's what's gonna make me happy today. And I'm actually kind of nervous. Actually, I take that back. I am not nervous at all. I am interested. Ooh, oh my gosh, what the heck? Okay, see, what are y'all doing? Truly, like, what? Yeah, I need everyone to stop slamming on the brakes. That would be really great. Like, amazing if people would stop doing that to get off of this, because people are driving like, what's wrong with y'all? Okay, y'all, so I just actually went to Target because I forgot that we needed some laundry detergent. So I just stopped at Starbucks in there and got my little green tea lemonade. It looks very dark, so I hope it's not too sweet. But it don't taste, it's like too much lemonade and not enough green tea, but whatever. So now we're going to go secure the crabs. When I drove past the place, because like the way that go, it's whatever, there wasn't a line. So that can mean one of two things. One, means nothing, they're just not super busy. Or two, they've run out of sizes that people want, so there's not a lot of people there. But I'm hoping it's the former, and it's just not a lot of people there, which is perfect for me. So we'll see. It's literally like across the street, so I'll be there in literally like 2 seconds. Target was kind of manic. Like, it was, but it wasn't. When I first came in, it was booming. I don't understand. It actually was a little bit ghetto. Somebody was getting very loud with one of the cashiers. So yeah, glad to be out of there, even though I love Target. And oh my gosh, y'all, I did good. I literally only bought the laundry detergent. I ain't buying nothing else. Like, not another thing. I should have went if I knew this girl was gonna go so slow. But I'm so proud of me. Like, I never only buy what I actually go into Target for. Like, I real life just went in Target and came out with one thing. Just giving myself controlled. It's not right. It's definitely too much lemonade. And I just knew. I could just tell. He was very nice, but I could just tell it wasn't right. The funny thing is, so many people, including me, complain about Starbucks drinks, and we keep going. We keep going. Like, it's an illness. It's literally an illness, and it has the strongest chokehold on us. I don't understand. It's just like Apple products. We're all fiends. Like, we literally, Apple changes like hardly anything on every product that comes out and we still run to go buy it. I'm a victim too. I'm talking about me. Don't worry. It's the way I do the most to avoid having to park next to people. And also when I be plotting my exit strategy, like I need my car to be somewhere where I can easily like leave, evacuate. All right, y'all, hopefully not a lot of people in here. We can get in and get out. My gosh, I just left my package in here with my address face up. So let's see, it's people coming out with bags and I know it's crabs in there. All right, y'all, BRB. Hey y'all, so I got my crabs. They big too. They didn't even have the swamp dogs. They only had super swamp dogs. So I had to get the big boys, but I'm excited. I only got like four because normally I would do a half dozen, but these the big daddies. So four was enough. I'm finally about to go home. I actually was waiting for mad long because when I went in initially, the guy was like, it was gonna be 15, 20 minutes before they got some bigger sizes. They only had large when I first went in there. And I do not, for I don't waste my money on small crabs. I don't really see the point A in using my time for small crabs because you do all that work for nothing. And then it's just not worth the money to me. So if it ain't like jumbo or swamp dog, I don't really buy them. And I'm so excited. First blue crabs of the summer. Well, it's not summer yet, but of the season. And the pandemic didn't stop crabs. So guess what's about to happen now that we, I'm not gonna say now that we outside because I ain't outside, but I'm excited. It's giving, is this a lane? I think it is, but still I can't really tell. Oh, it is a lane, a short lane here. So yes, now I'm on the way home to eat my crabs. Go-kart track is popping. I used to go there all the time. It is a lot of people out there. It's crazy how literally yesterday masks were required and today they're not. It's actually hilarious. Like, okay. Okay, y'all, I'm back home and I'm about to eat my crabs. So I'm just eating them in our little dining room because I thought I was gonna eat them in our sunroom, but there's like a wasp out there. I need to have somebody come look because for some reason, I don't know how like bees and stuff keep getting in there. That's part of the reason why I don't like going out there. But anyway, I'm about to eat my crabs and watch some YouTube videos, catch up on some of my favorite bloggers. Ooh, can y'all see? Oh my gosh. I'm so excited. I'm gonna just pull them all out. Do y'all see how big these are? They might not look that big on camera, but they're big for crabs and they're hefty. They got some weight on them. Yes. Oh, this is a heavy one. This one right here, this one heavy. So yeah, like I said, I only got four because they're big. Those crabs. Here's the aftermath. I demolished per usual. And they were so good. They were so good. But now I'm about to clean up and I think maybe I should do some laundry and then probably chill. I think it's a wrap for me doing anything productive. I think I'm just gonna start early tomorrow and yeah, go from there. So guys. It's another day. It's actually like 4 days. I don't know. It's Wednesday and I am eating toast. It's 6:30 in the evening and I'm having toast because I'm just on a toast kick right now. It's really good. I am on my way to the mall. Really just Zara. I'm on my way to the mall because I need to find something to wear this weekend. My friend is having a graduation celebration party thing and I want to look cute because this is low-key probably one of the last times I'm going out before the cicadas start taking over because I will not be leaving my house when they get here. But yeah, I just feel like I want to be cute, so I'm gonna see if I can find something cute to wear. And I feel like I'm doing good because her party's not till Saturday and it's Wednesday. Normally I would just wait until like Friday or Saturday to look for something, but look at us being ahead of the game and doing it early. But yeah, I'm hoping they will have something cutesy that I can wear because I want to be cute. And her party is at night, but I kind of want to do brunch before because it has been a long time. I told y'all, it's been forever since I have had brunch. And I just can't lose my brunch queen title like this. Like, I just can't. So, I want to go to brunch. I kind of want to make it a day thing. Like, I don't normally do two events in one day because she's an elder. But I'm thirsty to be out. So, yeah. That's a lie. I'm not thirsty to be out. I'm thirsty to go to brunch. So anyway, I need to go to like Target or something because I need more oat milk and more creamer. So I'll probably go to Target just because it's Target and I would love to go there instead of going to the grocery store to get what I need. So I'm gonna do that after. Why would you come on this back road if you scared? This is not the road for you to drive on. You scary. It's like this narrow back road. It's tight back here. I'm not even gonna fake. But like, this is not for everybody back here, honestly. Like, for a long time, I didn't even used to drive back here because it's just like treacherous. And God forbid a deer jump out. Like, my friend actually hit a deer back here. But there's nowhere for you to like swerve out of the way because there's literally like nothing. It's like a forest or like a ditch. I don't even know how to explain what it is. But like, it would almost do more damage to your car to try to swerve out of the way if you saw like a deer jumping out in front of you. Anyway, this car is driving really slow. This toast is so good. I hate my cousin for putting this bug in my ear because she literally be crushing toast. It's like her favorite thing. And then when I went to the store the other day, I was like, I want toast for breakfast. And ever since then, I've been hooked. Like, I don't even be buying bread like that. And after this loaf is gone, I'm not buying no more because clearly we don't have self-control for that. That was actually my second time having toast today. Granted, it's only 70 calories a slice. So it's not really that bad. And I didn't eat lunch. So I'm not mad at it, but also I just don't need to make it a habit of eating a lot of bread. So yeah, that's what I'm about to do now. And hopefully it's not busy. I mean, it's a Wednesday evening. It shouldn't be that busy, but then again, it's just hard to tell these days. Oh, I should get a slice of cheesecake while I'm over here. No. Maybe. I kind of want a slice of cheesecake. There's a cheesecake factory at this mall. And red velvet cheesecake is literally my favorite. But I should chill. I mean, I don't need it, obviously, but I want it. I'll decide when I get there. My brother asked me to bring him some snickerdoodle cookies back. So maybe I'll just have some of those. We're gonna see. So anyway, that's what I'm doing. Still, even though the sundown, I just finished at the mall and I did buy things, but not for Saturday. So I don't know what I'm about to do. I'm trying to think if I have anything cute already at home. Not really. But anyway, I did buy some cute stuff. A couple of things that I actually had in my online carts were in there, so I just grabbed them because instant gratification. And because, yeah, now I don't have to order it. So obviously still couldn't try anything on, which is annoying, but I only bought three things. And the cookie place, I don't know what happened to the cookie place, it's gone. And then I just decided I don't really want cheesecake, so I didn't get any. So I guess that's good on my part. So now I'm about to go to Target. I'm not gonna go to the one that's right here because it's just kind of a hassle to go into that one. It's got like a garage and you have to, it's too much. So I'm gonna go to the one that's a little bit closer to my house. I feel like I want something sweet. What am I gonna eat for dinner? It's giving very scatterbrained. I don't know. What do we want? I don't know. I'm hungry, but like high key, that toast really is doing something for me. Like, I was hungry before I left. That's why I made the toast. And like, I'm kind of good. So I don't know. Also, surprisingly, there were a lot of people at the mall, which is very weird. Well, I guess it's, oh, there's like a carnival. I would love a funnel cake and some fried Oreos. Oh my gosh, love that. Oh my gosh, I can't even think of the last time I went to like a fair or a carnival. or anything. The food is so unhealthy and delicious. Oh my gosh. It's so cute. Is it open? It's like nobody out there. Maybe they just got there. Yeah, no, because the food places aren't open. Oh my gosh, there's the funnel cake place. Let me see if I can turn this. Oh, it's too hard. It's too difficult. It's too hard. Sorry. That really just made me excited. Like, I miss doing things like that. Also, I took off my gel nail polish and now my nails look horrific. I'm just over everything. I'm over my hair. I'm over my nails. Like, I'm just over everything. No, I'm not. Actually, that's a lie. I need to get my nails done. And I think I'm gonna get braids soon. I feel like I told you guys that. But yeah, I think I'm gonna get braids soon just because my bun needs a break and I'm just tired of having to do things to my hair all the time. Not that I do anything, but like having to brush it into the bun every morning is like kind of a lot. And also it's just like, okay, can we please do something else other than this bun? Anyway, I'm about to go to Target and I'm about to turn on my music. So I will see you guys at Target.
Summer stuff, beach stuff. I can't wait. I want to get some like cute stuff for the beach. I wonder if they have the chair. Let's see. No matter what I do, I always pick a raggedy cart. Oh my gosh, like this is like picked over. Do they have the chair? It's like one of them. Has like flamingos on it. It's like for the beach. There was one like a lounge chair, but oh, look at the watermelon one. Of course, I've waited too late. I'm gonna have to look online and get it ASAP because I missed out on it last summer. I think that's all I need. I just need a coffee. I mean, I just need it. Look at the new creamer bottle shape. I like it. I think I have everything I need though. What else?
Hey guys, so it's another day. It's Saturday now and I am out and about being productive because y'all know me. But I'm at the bank now. I have to wait because I didn't have an appointment and there is no like agent available to help me with what I need. So I'm just waiting in my car until they come get me. Having my iced coffee per usual. This is like my favorite straw topper right now. Oh my gosh, y'all. It happened. It happened and I'm so sad. This is literally the last week and I'm going out. I open the door to go outside and what do I see outside on my steps? A cicada. It's over. It's over. It's over. After this weekend, I'm not going anywhere. And I would have to go to my friend's graduation. Oh, I told y'all. My friend's graduation party is tonight. I can't remember if the cicadas be out at night, but girl, still. Like, literally, the funniest thing is last night, me and my best friend were on the phone talking and she was telling me how somebody had posted on Instagram that they went outside and a cicada got on them and she was like, I'ma see y'all at the end of the summer. And I was like, oh my gosh, I hope that doesn't happen to me. Here we are next day and what's outside? Thank God it did not fly on me because I really would have like had to burn my clothes off and like bleach myself if, oh my gosh, please Lord, don't let one ever land on me. But it's just, and I know they don't even do anything. They don't bite, they don't do anything. They're just ugly and they're loud and I just don't like bugs and I really don't like them. So it's just, It's just a lot. So anyway, that's how I started my day. I was greeted by an ugly cicada when I opened the door. Thankfully, I put on my big girl panties and I was like, okay, you can do this. It's just a bug. I mean, I was moving very slowly so as not to like disrupt it and make it like fly. I slowly shut the door because I think it likes vibrations, like noise vibrations make it, I don't know. So I was like trying not to make a lot of noise. My car is so dirty. Not trying to make a lot of noise and slowly ran past it. Actually, I quickly ran past it, but I did everything else really slow, like shutting the door and like locking it. It was literally, I probably look so stupid, but I did it. So yeah, now I'm just sitting in my car waiting for my turn. After this, I have to go to another bank if they're not closed. It's 11:40. Hopefully I'll be done here before, because I think all the banks close at like 1 today. But yeah, I have to go to another bank. I need to get my nails done. I need to get a pedicure too. And what else? Oh, guys, there's a bug in here. Why me? Why does it have to happen to me? And the worst part is I paralyzed it so then it wouldn't fly away because I just crippled it. But like I said, it's giving about to be inside for the rest of the summer. Actually, not for the rest of the summer, but for the next 4 to 6 weeks until these cicadas die again. Which is, they're just so weird. Like, what made you make these, God? Like, why? For them to live and die in 4 to 6 weeks and then to just live under the ground for 17 years at a time. Like, I don't know. It's very weird. So, yeah, what else do I have to do today? I need to get a card for my friend. Probably should look for a little gift. I don't know. Or maybe a gift card. I don't know. I need to figure that out. But I do want to go to like Ross or TJ Maxx because it's near the other bank that I'm going to. And I just want to pop in and see if they have any nice mugs. I want some double wall mugs, glass mugs. I could just order them on Amazon, but you know how it, like, I keep seeing like one or two negative reviews out of the 2,000 good ones. And then it's just like, I don't know. I don't want them to break. And then I don't know. So I'm going to look and see because I have seen some in store before and I don't know why I didn't buy them, but I'm gonna look and hopefully I can find some, or I will just order them on Amazon. So what else did I say? I feel like there's something else I needed to do. I should get a car wash, but I can just already see that line, because it's gonna be 92 today, I think, and then it's like kind of supposed to be overcast, but then tomorrow it's supposed to be like 92 again and sunny. So oh my gosh, that just triggered in my mind Jumping by Destiny's Child. jumping. I don't know why I want to hear that. Oh, you ladies, leave your man at home. The club is full of bottles and their pockets full of gum. Why did I think of that? Haircut and your car wash too. And your... Okay. I'm gonna have to listen to it now. But yeah, guys, that's what's on the agenda for today. I have not been on a night move in, can't even tell you when. Literally can't tell you when. Like, I literally feel like I remember when, like, older people used to be like, yeah, it's over for going out late. And now I feel that, like, a 9 o'clock move, which, depending on where you live, that's not even late. But for me, because I'm a day party. I'm not even day party. I'm a brunch kind of girl. So I like daytime moves, daytime functions. I'm cool. I can rock with you all day. But the moment it starts getting dark, it's giving time to go home. It's giving need to be in sheets very soon. So I'm gonna have to, I don't know, probably take a nap or something after I run my errands to, you know, prep for tonight. Her virtual graduation is at 5, so I should be done doing what I need to do so I can watch. But I'm excited to see my friends. I feel like I haven't hung out with them in like a little while. So that's what we're doing today. I feel like, what else do I have planned for the weekend? I don't know. I really can't think of nothing else. Yeah, I don't know. Oh my gosh, I took an Instagram story of the cicada. Let me show y'all. Because I just could not believe I had to be greeted that way. Like, hi me. Actually, I'm just going to post it on here so y'all can see.
It happened. Oh my gosh. I just need to get home.
It's literally so ugly. I can't. So yeah, I'm about to listen to this new 42 Doug while I wait. And yeah, I'll check in with you guys. I don't know. At the next spot. Okay, bye. Okay, y'all. So I had no choice but to finally get some gas. I have been riding around with the gas light on for a couple days now. I mean, I did try to get gas the other day, but I don't know if they were running out of gas at the time. I tried 2 different pumps and none of them were working, so I left because I ain't got time. But now I'm getting gas. Oh my gosh, how is it already Bruh, I literally just turned the pump on, it's already at $35. Mind you, it generally only takes like $40 to fill up my car, maybe $45. I'm stopping it because I'm not putting $60 in my tank. I'm just not. So let me go stop this thing. Okay, I put 60 in there because it was moving fast, but ew, why would it ever be this much? It just actually doesn't make any sense, and I'm actually irritated by it. It did fill my tank up, probably would have taken a couple more dollars, but pew, why? It's definitely giving, this is my last weekend out for a while, because what the heck? It's just giving robbery with this gas. And then part of the problem is everybody overreacting and buying up the gas, creating said shortage. Like, I just can't believe y'all just did this. Like, this might be worse than the toilet paper last year, honestly. Like, people were really buying gas in bulk. Like, what? You know how dangerous that is, number one. Number two, you know how stupid that is. We've already seen a number of people's cars blowing up, catching on fire, rather, because they have excess amounts of gas in their car. Like, what goes on in people's heads? I just wonder. Like, it just really doesn't make much sense. Anyway, like I said, the tank is full now, but Babita's car, she won't be moving very much at this rate, because I'm not spending $60 to fill up this tank every time I need to fill it up. It's just not giving that at all. So, but yeah, so I got my nails done. Cute. I got it just plain white. I don't have the camera mounted today, but yeah, I just got cute white. Got my toes done. White, obviously, I only ever get white on my feet. And I found a cute little gift for my friend. I'm going to go to Target now to get a card. And then I'm going home. It is 4:15. I have been out all day. I didn't think it would take me this long. But I'm happy that I got my errands done that were, like, important this morning at the banks. So I'm very excited about that. Those were the main things. And one of the things I was concerned was going to be an issue. But it was seamless. It's giving favor. It's giving favor. And I'm going to always acknowledge that, because that part, it'd be the favor for me. But yeah, so now I'm going to Target, and then I need to deposit a check at the bank. But that's just like ATM. I can do that quickly through drive-thru. And I need to get something to eat. Then I'm going to go home and watch my friend's graduation at 5. And then get ready, because we're linking at my friend's house before we go to the, like, graduation party move. So yeah, that's what's happening right now. And I'm actually tired. I kind of need a nap, but it doesn't look like I will be able to sneak one in, because I need at least an hour and a half for my naps. And I don't know how long this graduation is, so I don't know. This is first world problem, like, obviously. But it's really irritating to me when the nail salons do not let you put a tip on your card. Like, I feel like it shortchanges the techs, because one, I don't carry cash, so I never have cash. Two, if you have an ATM in your shop, like, I'm not gonna use that, because those surcharges to use an ATM that's not your bank is ridiculous. And so I feel like that will deter people from getting cash out, because, like, I'm one of those people. I'm not using a random ATM. Like, that's a waste. That's literally money that could be going to the tip. And so yeah, I went to a new salon today, because I told y'all I'm looking for a new spot to go to that's, like, near my house, around my area, whatever. But yeah, they were like, you have to pay cash tip, which is annoying, because for the reasons I just said. So I'm just like, why are they still doing this? Like, low-key, actually not even low-key, high-key, if I worked at a place like that, I would be very irritated, because you're creating an inconvenience. And most people are not gonna go out of their way to tip. Like, you know what I'm saying? It's already not a requirement. I mean, you should tip, but it's just like, making it harder for people to tip is cutting into the tip that people should be getting. So yeah, I'm about to go into Target. I will see you guys in a second. Okay, y'all, we are in the sticks, basically, but it's cute. We're here for Keisha's graduation. Here's the graduate.
Hi, guys.
We got the Allen sisters in the building.
Alan.
Hello.
Because I have all these ideas, I just don't do it.
Hey guys. We are at Chris Kayla's.
Hey guys.
So it's really cute in here.
Where do they go?
I don't know.
The white thing, all that, yeah. But I think it's quite clear now. You need the bad guy.
Hey, Kyo. I'm the one who run the city where they armed and vicious. Accusations on them blogs and they all fictitious. I done bent the realest blocks, pushed the hardest sixes. Keep a couple killers that don't care how far them licks is. Look, bitches act like they want action, heard they want action. Bitch, we ain't ducking no action. I'm about to get them that traction, send a distraction. Then I'ma line them like fraction.
Take a break, I let them live, look at all them eating. But these bitches gon' be mad once I come.
Hey guys, so I just want to hop on and close out the vlog because I forgot to do that last night. So thanks so much for watching. As always, make sure you're subscribed if you're not already and like this video. And yeah, I will see you guys in my next video.